मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज 12th क्लास बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 9 स्ट्रेटजीज फॉर एनहांसमेंट इन फूड प्रोडक्शन एंड दिस इज फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एनिमल हस्बेंड्री, मैनेजमेंट ऑफ फार्म एंड फार्म एनिमल्स, अंडर विच यू विल स्टडी अबाउट डेयरी फार्म मैनेजमेंट एंड पोल्ट्री फार्म मैनेजमेंट। एंड नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एनिमल ब्रीडिंग एंड इट्स टाइप्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद एनिमल हस्बेंड्री। तो एनिमल हस्बेंड्री इज द साइंटिफिक एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस ऑफ ब्रीडिंग एंड रेजिंग लाइव स्टॉक। यू माइट हैव हियर्ड अबाउट द एग्रीकल्चर, दैट एग्रीकल्चर इज द रेजिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स, बट इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड द रेजिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट एनिमल्स ऑल्सो, राइट? सो हेयर इट इज द साइंटिफिक एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस ऑफ ब्रीडिंग एंड रेजिंग ऑफ लाइव स्टॉक विच इंक्लूड डिफरेंट फार्म एनिमल्स like buffaloes, cows, sheep, etc., right? So we can say animal husbandry deals with care and breeding of livestock like buffaloes, cows, pigs, horses, cattle, sheep, camels, goats, etc. Also it includes the poultry farming and fisheries. According to different data, 70% of world livestock population is in India and China. But contribution to the world farm produce is only 25%. It means that productivity per unit is very low. So productivity in India is very low. Hence, new technologies should be applied to achieve improvement in quality and productivity. So to improve the quality and the quality of the food and also to increase the productivity per unit area, there is requirement of new technologies. Our next topic is management of farm and farm animals. Under this topic, first we will discuss about the dairy farm management. So dairy farm management is the management of animals for increasing yield and quality of milk and its products. So here management of animals is done for increasing the milk yield and to improve the quality of milk and its products. Here milk yield depends on the quality of breeds in the farm. So this is the most important thing about the management of dairy farm. And what is this? This is quality of breeds. So breeds of animals is the most important thing, okay? Because it milk yield depends on the breeds of the animals, right? So it is important to select good breeds of the animals. And which breeds of the animals are considered good breeds? The breeds, or the you can say the animals which have high yielding potential, means which are the animals which can provide high quantity of milk, okay, means having high yielding potential, and also the animals having resistance power to diseases. So animals which are resistant to diseases and which can provide more milk are considered good breeds of the animals. So first of all, good breeds of animals are selected. This is the first step for the dairy farm management. These are some other points for the dairy farm management, and these are also called ways for yield potential. So first is look after the cattle, and for looking after the cattle, there should be housing well, means the place where the cattle are kept. That place should have all the basic facilities, okay? It should have adequate water, and also it should be maintain disease free, okay? Disease free condition should be there around the cattle. Next thing is feeding of cattle. Feeding of cattle is also very important point for the dairy farm management, and feeding of cattle should be in scientific manner. In scientific manner means there should be a particular quality and the quantity of the fodder, okay? So there should be emphasis on the quality and quantity of the fodder. Like at the different time periods, different types of food can be given to the cattle. Like at the time of lactation, cattle need more proteinaceous food, okay? So according to that, quality and quantity of fodder can be changed. So that is called a scientific manner. Next is stringent cleanliness and hygiene of cattle. So cleanliness and hygiene is also very important of both cattle as well as of handlers. Handlers means which handle the milk and other milk products. Okay, so cattle and handlers cleanliness and hygiene is important for the dairy farm management. So handlers while milking and also the storage of the milk and the transport of milk and its products. So during all these things, cleanliness is important. Next is how to ensure these stringent measures, means how these management conditions, these management strategies can be checked. So first is regular inspections to identify and rectify the problems, and next is regular visit by a veterinary doctor. So visit by a veterinary doctor is very important for any dairy farm management. Next topic is poultry farm management. In poultry, the domesticated birds used for food or eggs. So here, birds are used for food or for eggs. For example, chicken, ducks, turkey and geese. These are name of some birds which are used for food and for the eggs. Here, chicken and duck. These birds are shown here. And other than these birds, turkey and geese are also used for the poultry. Next is components of poultry farm management. So during the poultry farm management, these things should be kept in mind. First is selection of disease-free and suitable breeds. So that is similar to that of the dairy farm management. In dairy farm management also, the first point is to selection of good breeds, right? So here for the poultry farm management also, there is need of selection of disease-free and suitable breeds, means good breeds of birds are selected. Second thing, proper and safe farm conditions, right? Housing well, that was a condition for dairy farm management also, and here for poultry farm management also, this is the condition. Housing well means proper and safe farm conditions. Next is safe farm condition, mean it should be disease free and it should have adequate amount of water also, right? Next is proper feed and water, right? So feeding should be in scientific manner here also, like the dairy farm management. Next is hygiene and health care. So hygiene is required for poultry farm management also. Next topic is animal breeding, and to understand the animal breeding, first you need to know about the breed, that what is a breed. So breed is a group of organisms related by descent, means the group of organisms having a common ancestor. Okay, so the group of organisms having a common ancestor will be related by descent, and these organisms also have similar general appearance, features, size, etc. So we can say a group of organisms having the same having the similar general appearance, features, size, and which are having the common ancestor and which are related by the descent are said to belong to a common breed. Now what is breeding? You can say the mating between two animals can be called breeding. Okay, so breeding is the modification of genotype of an organism to make that organism more useful to humans. So you know what is genotype? Set of genes and all its alleles present in any organism is called its genotype, right? So if the modification in genotype is done for the human welfare, to making that organism more useful to the human, that is called breeding. Okay, for example, Jersey is an improved cattle breed and Leghorn is an improved chicken breed. Okay, aim of animal breeding. So aim of animal breeding is to increase and improve the yield and desirable qualities of animals. So with the help of animal breeding, yield can be improved and also some desirable characteristics in animals can be obtained. Now there are two types of breeding, inbreeding and outbreeding. First, let's discuss about inbreeding. So inbreeding is the mating of more closely related individuals. More closely related individuals means the individuals having common ancestors. Okay, so here closely related individuals are mated within the same breed. Okay, these individuals belong to the same breed and are closely related. These are mated here for 4 to 6 generations. So such upbreeding, or you can say such a mating, is called inbreeding. A mating in which closely related individuals having common ancestors are mated for 4 to 6 generations is called inbreeding. The breeding strategy means how the inbreeding is done. So first of all, identify and mate superior males and females of same breed. So first of all, superior male and females are identified. Okay, and these males and females should belong to the same breed. So male and female from the same breed are identified first. This superior male and female are identified on the basis of their different characteristics, like their yielding potential or their disease resistance power. Okay, so those are called superior males and females. Next is evaluate the progeny obtained and identify superior males and females among them for further mating. So the progeny obtained by this first mating is obtained. Okay, and from that progeny also superior males and females are identified and again those are mated. Next is advantages of inbreeding. So first, inbreeding increases homozygosity to evolve pure line variety. So due to inbreeding, there will be increase in homozygosity. Homozygosity means homozygous condition. I hope you remember the homozygous condition that you have studied in principles of inheritance chapter, right? So in homozygous condition, the you can say both the alleles will be of same type, right? So here, due to inbreeding, you know, as in inbreeding, closely related individuals are mated. Okay, so there will be chances of homozygosity, means the same type of allele will come together generation after generation. Okay, so it increases homozygosity, and if the homozygosity is increasing, pure line variety will be evolved, right? And due to this, it exposes harmful recessive genes. If the recessive genes are present in homozygous condition, it can express itself, right? So because due to inbreeding, homozygosity is increasing, that's why there are chances of harmful recessive genes to get expressed. Okay, and we can say these harmful recessive genes will get exposed, and due to their expression, or you can say due to their exposure, those can be eliminated by selection. Means that you can say the animals having those harmful recessive genes can be eliminated. Okay, and only the animals having the useful genes will be selected generation after generation. So we can say it helps in the accumulation of superior genes. Okay, because we will select only the superior genes, so accumulation of superior genes will be there generation after generation, and the harmful genes can be eliminated, and elimination of less desirable genes, or you can say the harmful genes. Okay, so this increases the productivity of inbred population. So due to this, there will be increase in the productivity. Now there is some disadvantage also of inbreeding, and that is called inbreeding depression. So what is inbreeding depression? Let's see here. It is the depression of fertility, means decreased fertility, and productivity, means decreased productivity due to continued inbreeding. So due to continuous inbreeding, there is decreased fertility and productivity. That is called inbreeding depression, especially close inbreeding. Okay, so continuous inbreeding leads to decreased fertility and the productivity. That is called inbreeding depression. Now, how to solve this problem? Mate selected individuals with unrelated superior animals of the same breed. Okay, so here what is done to overcome the inbreeding depression? Selected animals are mated with unrelated superior animals of the same breed, and by one mating, this inbreeding depression can be overcome. You can understand the inbreeding depression with the help of this chart. You see here, capital A allele is representing the dominant allele here, which is for the useful character, and small a is representing recessive allele or the deleterious allele, that is responsible for the harmful character, right? So in inbreeding, closely related animals are mated. Okay, so these animals are mated first of all here, and out of these two cattle, one is having the condition capital A small a, and another is having condition capital A capital A. Okay, so in the progeny, there will be condition like this, capital A capital A, and the condition capital A small a. Okay, and also this cattle is having capital A small a. So again, the mating between the progeny, because that is the condition for inbreeding. Okay, so here also this is the progeny. Okay, and in the progeny, these two cattle are mated. Okay, that is called inbreeding. Okay, so here these two cattle are having the condition capital A small a. Okay, so in their progeny, there will be chances of the chances that the small a will come in homozygous condition, right? Because both the parents are having the small a, right? So in the next progeny, this small a will express itself, means this deleterious allele will express itself because it has come here in homozygous condition, as you can see here. Okay, so due to this homozygous condition, it express itself, and this leads to inbreeding depression. Now how it can be overcome? You see here, just by an outbreed cross, means the here what has been done, this is the cattle from any other breed. Okay, or it can be from the same breed which is not closely related. Okay, so this is called outbreeding. Okay, if it belongs to the different breed. So here, mating between these two can overcome the inbreeding depression. So this is the method that how inbreeding depression can be overcome. You make this flowchart in your notebook, and it will be easier to understand that how the inbreeding depression can occur and how it can be overcome. Okay, so it can be overcome like this. Now next is outbreeding. So outbreeding is the breeding of unrelated animals, and these unrelated animals can be from different breed. These can be of different species. Okay, or these means that ancestors can be different. Okay, so there are different types of outbreeding. So these are types of outbreeding. These are outcrossing, crossbreeding, and interspecific hybridization. Right, start with outcrossing first. Outcrossing is the mating of animals within the same breed but having no common ancestors up to 4 to 6 generations. Okay, so in outcrossing, what is the condition? Breed is same, but ancestors are not common. Okay, so no common ancestor up to 4 to 6 generation, but the breed is same. So I hope this is clear that how it is different from inbreeding. In inbreeding also, the breed is same, but the individuals are having common ancestor. Okay, but here in case of outcrossing, these are not having common ancestor up to 4 to 6 generation. Okay, they have a gap. So this is outcrossing, and this is outcrossing, and this is a type of outbreeding. Okay, the offspring of such a mating is known as outcross. So offspring of the outcrossing is called outcross. Now what is the advantages of outcrossing? It is the best method for animals having low milk productivity, growth rate in beef in beef cattle, etc. Okay, and also it helps to overcome the inbreeding depression, as I have told you. Next is crossbreeding. Next type of outbreeding you can say is crossbreeding. In crossbreeding, in this method, superior males of one breed are mated with superior females of another breed. So here breeds are different. So male from one breed and female from another breed is taken here. Okay, and those superior males and females from different breeds are mated here. Okay, so this is crossbreeding. Now, desirable qualities of two different breeds are combined. So what is done here? We are selecting superior males and superior females from two different breeds. So we can say the desirable qualities of two different breeds are combined here, right? The progeny hybrid animals may be used for commercial production. So here hybrid animals are used for the commercial production, or may be subjected to inbreeding and selection to develop new stable superior breeds. Okay, once after selecting the superior males and females from the different breeds, further in their progeny inbreeding can be done, so that these can be protected. Okay, those useful characters can be preserved for the next generations. Okay, now these are some examples of crossbreeding, like Bikaneri ewes, merino rams and Hisar Dale. Okay, these are different examples which have been obtained from crossbreeding by mating of the males and females from different breeds. Now next topic is interspecific hybridization. You can say next type of outbreeding. Okay, it is the mating of male and female animals of two different species. So here two different species, males and females are taken. Okay, and those are mated. In some cases, the progeny may combine desirable features of both the parents and may be of considerable economic value. So here also, desirable characteristics of two different species are combined, so that a new animal having the desirable characteristic of both the species can be obtained, and sometimes it can be of high economic value. Okay, one example of interspecific hybridization is given here, that is mule. So mule is a result of interspecific hybridization between male S and female horse. Okay, so male S and female horse, these are two different species, and when these two are mated, mule are obtained. Here you can see the cross between the horse and the donkey, and mule has been obtained from the cross of these two. Now, based on today's topics, your homework is NCERT question number 1, 2 and 3. Thank you.